Hi, welcome to the session. This is module 2, unit 1, equilibrium of forces. I am Sunil HG, working as assistant professor in the department of civil engineering in Sai Vidya Institute of Technology. Now let's see the contents. In this unit we are going to cover free body diagrams, Lamy's theorem, equations of equilibrium, then equilibrium of concurrent and non-concurrent coplanar force systems. So only this much is the content. Out of that, the content highlighted in the green color indicates that it contains derivation. The content indicated in the red color indicates that it contains numerical problems, both on the concurrent as well as non-concurrent coplanar force system subjected to the equilibrium. Now if you come to the introduction to the equilibrium, what do you mean by equilibrium? Suppose consider a body, let us apply some forces. So even after the application of several forces, if the body remains in rest position, then the body is said to be in equilibrium. A body is said to be in equilibrium when it does not have any translatory or rotatory motion in any direction. Translatory motion is nothing but horizontal or vertical motion, or it may be inclined motion. Rotatory motion is nothing but rotation, clockwise or anticlockwise. Now the general conditions of equilibrium, nothing but if the body should be in rest, if the body should be in equilibrium, which are the condition to be satisfied in generally? In generally, sum of the forces in x direction should be 0, sum of the forces in y direction should be 0, sum of the moment should be 0. That is, sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0, and sigma m is equal to 0. Where sigma fx is equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0 are translatory motions. Sigma m is equal to 0 is the rotatory motion. Okay. Next, what do you mean by free body diagram? A free body diagram is a diagram drawn by detaching the body from its attachments with surroundings and replacing the attachments with the force vector. For example, consider a ball resting on a floor. We can write this given diagram as a free body diagram. We know that every body will be having its own weight, self weight. So the weight will always act vertically downwards. We wrote the action, that is weight acting downward on the floor. And according to the Newton's third law, for every action there will be equal and opposite reaction. So we wrote the reaction for that. Reaction always acts perpendicular to the roller plane at the contact point. Reaction always acts perpendicular to this contact plane at the contact point. So this will be the free body diagram. We can represent this given diagram as the free body diagram. I will define one more time. A free body diagram is a diagram drawn by detaching the body from its attachments with surroundings and replacing the attachments with force vector. In simple words, we can say the diagram should consist of only the magnitude, direction and position of the forces. Direction, magnitude, direction and position of the forces. We need to worry about only these three. The next one is Lamy's theorem. What does it says? The Lamy's theorem states that if a body is in equilibrium under the action of only three forces, each force is proportional to the sine of the angle between other two forces. For example, consider a particle or a body. Upon that, three forces are acting on it. Nothing but all the three forces are meeting at a single point. Consider a particle. Upon that, three concurrent forces are acting. So in that case, then each force is proportional to the sine of the angle between other two forces. then each force is proportional to the directly proportional to the sine of the angle between other two forces. Then here we need to derive the Lamy's theorem. For that proof is, let us consider PQR be the three concurrent forces in equilibrium as shown in the figure. Please be careful, all these three forces should act away from the point or should act towards the point. Then, since the forces are vectors, nothing but having both magnitude and the directions, we can move them to form a triangle as shown in the figure B. Then, applying the sine rule for this triangle, we get the force, that is P, divided by sine of the opposite angle. Opposite angle is 180 minus beta, 180 minus alpha, equals to Q divided by sine of 180 minus beta or divided by sine of 180 minus theta. We know that sine of 180 minus theta is nothing but sine theta. So, by using that rule, we will get final equation as P by sine alpha equal to Q by sine beta equals to R by sine theta. This will be the Lamy's theorem equation. We will make use of this equation to solve the problems, and hence that derivation is proved. Then, what are the limitations of this Lamy's theorem? It is only limited to the Lamy's theorem applicable only for equilibrium of the forces. Then, Lamy's theorem is used only for three forces, not more than three forces or not less than three forces. This theorem is applicable only when three concurrent forces are acting at a point. All the three forces should act towards the point or away from the point. Then Lamy's theorem is applicable only when maximum number of unknowns are two only. There are three forces. Out of that, if all the three forces are unknown, we can't solve the problem. So, out of the three forces, two forces may be unknown. Then we can solve the problem. The maximum unknowns in the Lamy's theorem is two. Then, equations of equilibrium. The necessary and sufficient conditions for a body to be in equilibrium. If the body to be in equilibrium, then which are all the conditions? We have two types of force system, that is concurrent as well as non-concurrent force system. For coplanar concurrent force system, nothing but if all the forces are acting at a single point, then equilibrium conditions are sigma fx is equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0. For coplanar non-concurrent force system, the equilibrium conditions are sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0 and sigma m is equal to 0. Nothing but horizontal, vertical and moment should be 0. Then, thank you. That's all for this video.